This is a dedication to Carlos Tate Sr., from your brother, Wallace, Jr., and the entire WGURFM family. Now, for the presentation. This is a dedication.
Hey, yo, Light.
This is Bubba Dundado, you know what I'm saying, live from Maxwell Federal Prison Camp. You know what I'm saying, doing the beat, you know what I'm saying, trying to school everybody out there, keep your mouth shut, keep your enemies close and your friends close, you know what I'm saying. I'm out, 2020.
Wallace Jr. put your ass on blame.
Cause you know Wallace Jr. been my A1 since day one, so I damn know the nigga in this bitch to say something.
Hey, Jason Mahone, where we pull up, man. I had left my blood pressure and my heart pressure in the car. Go out there and get on with your blow. Man, go out there and get on with your water. Man, we just keep back my mind. You dig? And my car low, man. Straight up, right at home. I think about this nigga every day. I mean, every day. Looking at the tattoo on me, there, man. She like my old shit, that boy. You know, really love that nigga, man. No, man. Shit was supposed to happen, nigga. That's how I represent him, dog. Shit, nigga. His face needs to be seen, nigga, every day, nigga. Nigga was a king, cuz. Nigga was a real, live king, just. Some of that nigga was blessed by God for real, dog. Shit, what nigga got some in the tree making head spin? If you see them all together, you think you're on a horror movie, nigga. Shit, scared the fuck out of you, they look so much like him, dawg. Well, everything.
Shit, why you riding? You that nigga on. You make me call it for real, dawg.
Hell yeah, nigga, what you, man, that's a stupid ass question, Jason. You know what time it is with that, man. That was like the only nigga I had around besides Boone and my nigga that was like, cause I'm a killer about that. And my blood, man, they're my people, man. We came up in life together. God gave me him to walk through life with, man. That was my partner, man.
Yeah, I don't know what a good old dude, man. Do anything, man.
You know why
the dude in
my
A1
since day one, so why damn those niggas in the mid-season?
But not me, shut the fuck up, Jesse, man. Fuck out my face, man. Stupid ass shit, you stupid ass nigga.
Yeah, no one was a good old nigga, man. He was a damn good nigga, boy. He was a damn good nigga.
So, yeah, he was. Yo, I'm here to pay my respects today, man, with Carlos. Tate, my brother, man. I miss him, man. Dilly, man. Just pay a homage to a true king, you know what I mean? True, true Godfather, man. I ain't talking about just using them words loosely, man. This man was blessed. You know what I mean? But I met Lou, man. I was about 7 years old when I met Carlos, man. You know what I mean? And from 7 years on out, nigga, it was over. Till the nigga died, man. Cause we was day for day niggas, man. Even if I was out of town on some shit, man, that was my dude, man. Carlos was my nigga, dog. I swear to God, that was my brother, bro. I fucking knew about Lou, man. But, man, we walked through life together, man. I'm talking about we shared life together every step of the way, man. Even though he was his own man, I was my own man. And we were totally different. We were so much alike. We had so much in common, man. 7 years old and out, man. We was out there, boy, doing what we do. You know, I can recall Carlos coming around the house and eat and shit sometimes. That nigga used to love some goddamn cornflakes, man. That nigga smashed them hoes. And that nigga would've been a hustler. That nigga had a diamond back, the mongoose, the mags on the bike and shit. We was in the tricycles like niggas in the motorcycles. And that nigga kept that exotic shit, the white boys have. I mean, how he got the shit as a business. But one time they gave me a dime in the back frame for a box of goddamn closet plate. Shit, mama was like, hey, boy, what I'm calling about? I wish my blow, I wish my blow. Sorry, mom, sorry. Shit, I gave a call the whole box, they wouldn't even know. But come to find out, man, nigga, mom had got strung out on drugs and shit when it first hit. You know, when that crack first hit, it tricked everybody. I didn't know they were getting something too. And shit, man, shit was kind of rough around this way, man, but same demon that attacked his family, man, and then Carlos would get beat by the neck and rolled that motherfucker at a young age, boy. Carlos around there booming, man, the true hustle, man, nigga put some things together, man, and then they were about the issue with him when he came there and his brother, you know what I mean? So shit, what's up, Tate? That my brother, too, that my folk, too. Them niggas had adopted me for real. But me and Lowe coming up, man, there wasn't no stopping, dog. There wasn't no limitations, man. For some strange reason, as kids, man, we was into that money, man. I'm talking, we straight grinding, dog. I remember one time the fool, yeah, he used to go to Zales and steal them little electronic games and shit, man. Handheld Tiger games and shit, man. Just stealing them hoes and shit, ride the bikes up there and shit. The fools wanted to try to get greedy, and got caught, man. All them damn time we went in that bitch and been bombing them all the way. Them kids take their ass up there and get caught. Yeah, man, that just tickled me, man. But Low was always my dude, my age, my round, man, for life. Then he was like my brother, cuz. It wasn't shit I wouldn't do for that nigga, dog. I'm talking about I moved mountain for him, man. On everything, and, ooh, boy, I still remember that day, man. When I seen him in that box, cuz that shit changed my life, man. That shit was very life-changing. I'm just say that. Cause that's the first time and the only time I ever seen Dale, dog. When I looked at my folks in that box, man, and looked at him, I really seen Dale. I'm talking about I never seen that again at a funeral. But when I looked at my dog and know he wasn't here no more, I seen Dale, man. And it was the true definition, man. I ain't never come back from that. I ain't never bounced back from that. I was traumatized. Shit, it wasn't shit me and Carla wouldn't do. I buy a Carla nigga go match me. I buy a nigga, he'll buy a nigga. Young nigga, man. Getting it. And shit, that nigga was A1 hustle, you know what I mean? He actually was brought into the game with no choice. You know what I mean? He had to do for his family, man. He make shit happen. Carla was taped with forever. King, my nigga. Where I'm from, that nigga forever, his name will forever be crowned king, man. That nigga was a God-fearing man. He taught me a lot about God, man. I'm talking about it wasn't nothing, man, this nigga wouldn't do, man. I'm talking about because it didn't matter, man, nigga. I was like one of the first niggas with the cell phone, with the beepers and all that shit, man. I get that shit to that nigga, let him go on by their business, man. We young niggas. I'm talking about, man, nigga 16 and shit, man. We was wild. Nigga got in the band just to go out of town and freak girls and shit. We was grown a long time ago before our time, man. And I miss him, man. You know what I mean? Straight up, that nigga was live like that.
Man, my whole life changed when I seen Los in that casket, man. Nigga, funeral was so packed, dog. Motherfuckers couldn't even... They had to put a speaker outside and continue to serve it outside in the rain, man. There was so many motherfuckers came to pay their respect, dog, to a true godfather, a true king, man. The nigga was humble, dog. He was a very special dude, man. The nigga was angelic, dog. That nigga was special, dog. That nigga was humble as they come. Somebody, you know, nigga sending dope all night and riding the bicycle to church to pay your tithes, man. I mean, I never met a nigga like that dude, man. Nigga wasn't violent at all, man. I mean, I wanted to kill niggas by fucking with the nigga, man. He'd just be like, man, kill him with kindness, what? Lord, go ahead. Kill him with kindness. I'm talking about, this is me young, man. Nigga like 21 years old, nigga, and robbed you, nigga, and took everybody the money. You rounded up everybody the money in the hood and went out of town to go cop the work, and this nigga ran off with everybody the money. Man, fuck that nigga. He don't know me. I'ma serve this nigga. Let's go. Nah, man, we don't do it like that, man. It's gonna be all right. What you mean it's gonna be all right? Everybody in here wanna ready to kill your ass by their money, nigga. You gotta go see about this, man. Just calm down, man. Kill him with kindness, Wally. I never forget Los, man. Nigga put a lot of real shit inside of me, dog. Nigga put a lot of godly ways inside of me, man. I got him tattooed on my neck right now, man, because he was the real nigga I ever met. He was my brother, man. Carlos Tate, man. I'm talking about real king nigga, man. Real godfather nigga, for real, dog. He died young, man. I see why God took him, because he's still here. You know what I mean? That nigga was a legend, man. A legacy, dog.
his spirit was so humble, dog. I mean, and he died peaceful, dog. But me seeing him in that box, emotionless, no energy, no spirit, cause that shit changed my life. Even now, I still hear him, man, telling me to tighten my ass up, man, and get back out there and get back about it. Fuck that hard failure shit, man. We ain't slack. I mean, I still hear the nigga coaching me, man. But when I seen the nigga dead and gone, cuz it took my breath away, it changed my life, man. I ain't been right since, you know what I mean? Shit ain't been the same since, man. Low died, man. Stop giving a fuck about a whole bunch of shit in the hood. Period, you know what I mean? Man, talking with his baby mama, man, Deidre. What's up, Deidre? She told me, man, nigga had a surprise for me before he died. Nigga had started stacking cheese, man. Nigga finna put a grip behind me with the rap shit. I mean, because he knew what I was trying to do, and I was trying so hard, and he was telling Deidre, man, Wally gonna make it. Nigga, you need some bread behind him so he can do what he gotta do. And then nigga had started rising and stacking up a budget for me, my nigga, to put behind me in the rap game, cuz. To put me out there so I could do my thing, man. That's how much that nigga believed in me, man. That was my brother, dog. That was my brother for real. And knowing his slick ass, man, that nigga got a couple $100,000 somewhere in the can, underground in the bush some damn well. Cause that's how that nigga was, man. Carlo Tate, man, Cross Tent legend, dog. Cross Tent king. Cross Tent godfather, dog. All his children gonna be blessed, man. I mean, that was like the realest nigga I had in my life, dog. That was the realest nigga I had around me, man. That nigga didn't never change up, dog. I don't give a fuck who you around, my nigga. That nigga ain't fake break on me, man. That nigga ain't never turned his back on me, man. When you have a problem with me, man, you straight up told me what the business was. Look, man, you like this. I can't fuck with you like that. I can't deal with that. Man, nigga on some real nigga shit, man. I miss that nigga, man. And that's why I dedicated my album to him. Surviving Underground Chapter 2. Donnie Hello. I love the Carlos Tate, cause I gotta write my dog and let him know what's going on with me, man. Been a while since I seen him and talked to him, dog. You know what I mean? And the nigga who did the tattoo, man. 4 fucking years I had the biggest piece of shit ass nigga to do the tattoo, man. This nigga didn't even give a fuck about Low, cuz. Nigga knew how I felt about Carlos, man. Nigga ain't give a fuck about none of that, man. Nigga bullshit around with my dog, man. Putting that my dog on my flesh. And I told him, I said, cuz, I better not die before he get on my neck, my nigga. All due respect, man, this nigga fucking me around, man, and fucking me over, man, on that dope and shit. I mean, bro, that's this tattoo sentimental, my nigga, and I still feel like it wasn't his best work. He still asked me around, rest job. You know what I mean? It is what it is, man. Cross 10 for life, dog. I mean, right on to the real. Death to the fakers, nigga. All hell and long live. Carlos Tate. King Snow, nigga. This goes on and on and on. We got Bassoot, Sherry Lane, Lil Nate, Bonnie, Joe Sammy. I mean, this goes on, man. There's a lot of niggas dead and gone. I want to give a special shout out to my nigga Rambo, you know what I mean? That's my OG. He took care of me in the street, man, when I was a little nigga. Selling dope on that porch, man. He knocking niggas out because they big and this shit. All in my face, man. That nigga was my goon, man. He really my stepdad, my street dad. Watching out for me when I was working and selling that dope, working that work. He taught me a lot about the game, man. I remember when this nigga used to go in the backyard and he'd drop a motor. This nigga was picking motors up out the ground, man, with a cherry pickle backhanded, dropping them in cars, man. Nigga was real ass, throwback ass nigga, man. They don't build niggas like that no more. The world fucked up, man. I mean. So that's why I'm just gonna fall back, man. Produce this knowledge and wisdom. Hang around my kind, teach mine, you know what I mean? Teach the ones that I'm sent to teach. Embrace the love, man. Develop their energy, man. Just keep pushing, man. Long live Carlos Tate, man. R.I.P. to my brother. Right on to the real and death to the fakers, nigga. Cross 10 for life, nigga. Y'all know what it is. All cool skills, I love you, baby. All right, Pete. We out of here.
Wallace Jr., put your ass on blast.
I'd rather die than to continue living away. With your pride and care.
done it all, you know what I'm saying?